Hello guys, in the previous video we have discussed about basic concept of bridge and components of arch bridge. Today we will learn about girder bridge by simple concept. So what is girder? Girder is a type of a large beam. We know beam is a horizontal member of a structure used to carry vertical load and transfer the load to column, then footing, then soil. Girder is also a large horizontal member of a structure to carry heavy loads and transfer the load to bearing, then substructure. Girders are mainly having I-shaped and box-shaped cross-section. The girder having I-shaped cross-section is called as I-girder and having box-shaped cross-section is called as a box-girder. Functionally, beam and girder are having same principle to resist bending moment, shear force and torsional resistance. So what is the fact which differentiate beam to girder? Well, the interesting point is beam is designed to carry static load and girder is designed to carry dynamic load. Static load is a constant load with respect to time, like a slab is resting on the beam. And dynamic load means a load changes in magnitude, direction and position with respect to time, such as wind loads, forces by water current, seismic loads due to earthquake and rolling loads like a running car. Now the point is why beams are rectangular in shape and girders are I or box shaped. Let's take a look. Suppose this is a beam with rectangular cross section having a length L, width B and depth D. Have you ever noticed why the depth of beam is always more than the width? Let's assume this scale as a beam, which is simply supported and a point load is acting on the middle of the beam length and the beam is having width B and depth D, where B is greater than D. Now the position of scale and arrangement of loads are like this. So what will happen when the loads will act? The beam will bend like this, even by a small load. Let's see if we alter the width and depth of beam. Now the depth D is greater than the width B. And this is the position of scale and loads right now. So what will happen in this case when the loads will act? It's impossible to bend. Let's explain mathematically. Suppose again, this is a simply supported beam having a length L, width B and depth D and a point load W is acting on the mid of the beam. Again the beam will bend like this. This is delta, the deflection of beam, which is the distance between the position of axis of beam before and after loading, equals to WL cube divided by 48EI, where L is the length of the beam, W is the point load intensity acting vertically, E is the modulus of elasticity, which is a constant, and I is the moment of inertia. For a rectangular section, I is equal to BDQ divided by 12. By simplifying the formula, we get delta equals to WL cube divided by 4EBD cube. In this formula, we can clearly understand that if we increase the width by 2 times, the deflection will be half of the previous deflection. But if we increase the depth by 2 times, the deflection will be surprisingly 1/8 of the previous deflection. That's why depth is more important than the width of the beam. And the innovation of girder from beam to carry heavy loads in longer span by increase the depth rather than the width, which is more effective in reducing the bending. But there is a problem. On increase the depth, the deep section may be bent like this, which is called as buckling. To avoid buckling, this rectangular section is provided on the both ends of girder, which provide a large load-bearing surface. In this I section, when load will act as simply supported, bending compression will be at the top section. It resists the compressive stress. Bending tension will be at the bottom section. It resists tensile stress. And the mid portion will resist the beam to bend, which is the bending stress. In a I section, the top and bottom horizontal elements are called flanges. And the vertical element on the middle is called as web. This combination of elements make this section so stronger that it used in bridges with long span as a main superstructure member. And if you notice at the rails on railway track, that is also a I section to resist heavy load. In the box girder, there are also two flanges in the top and as well as in the bottom. Having two webs and wider flanges makes the box girder more stronger than I girder. In the next video, we will learn about other components of a girder bridge by simple concept. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and click on the bell to turn on the notification.